Hello guys, and welcome to the first showcase episode of Nystad Building Server. I'm so happy to announce that the server is finally open, so just come and join. Our IP is in the top right corner as well as in the description below. You can also find our Discord in the description below. So, today's episode is not going to be an ordinary showcase episode. Instead, I'm just going to go over some useful information as well as show the progress on the city so far. So yeah, for people that don't know who we actually are, we're basically a building team or building community that shares ideas in our Discord as well as we build stuff both individually and both together on our server. For example, we have a huge Minecraft modern city that we are building together, as well as each builder gets their own yard where they can work on their private projects. So, when you join the server, you'll join as a citizen. So, to get builder, you'll actually need to apply for that. And you can do that at Warp Plots. And here at Plots, you can do Plot Auto to claim your first plot. I'm not going to claim another plot because I have already claimed like 10. But then you get a small little plot here where you can where you should build as good as you can, and when you are done with your application, just call on a staff member or the owner, which is me, and we will review it. If it's good enough, then you're officially part of the building team. So as a builder, when you have builder, you can actually build in this creative world over here. You also get permission to world edit. So each builder in the creative world gets their own kind of very huge yard. We can take my yard as an example. It's a 1100 by 1100 blocks yard. And in this yard you can do whatever you want to. The yards are not here to limit you, they are used to keep the server world more organized, I guess. So if you build something you think looks really cool and you want me to show it off in these showcase episodes, then you can go to the board over here, take a sign, fill it out with all of this information. So we can take my build as an example. So my name is FLG, my build is a school perhaps. My warp is FLG, and from the warp I should follow white. So these things, warp and follow, is just so I know what in your yard I should show off. So now when I do showcase videos, I know that I should do warp FLG. By the way, all the yards get their own warp. And then follow the white to find the actual building. And then I will show it off. So, now I'm not going to show it off today, but yeah. There's also another rank called City Planner, and it's City Planner that actually gives you permission to build in the city. And to get City Planner, you just need to be active on the server, prove your building skills a bit more, because in the plot world you don't really have room to build anything advanced. So, the yards gives you an opportunity to actually prove your skills a bit more. The most crucial part about getting City Planner though is to prove that you actually can communicate with other players and plan along with many other City Planners, because this is obviously a project that we are working on together, so well, many players are working on it. Yeah, and that also brings us to the city rules. I'm just going to go over them very briefly. Yeah, when you start your build, I recommend you to mark it out with these building codes. I mean, it does not need to be advanced, I can show you an example. You see here, I just planned out, this is supposed to be a train station. This is just so other players know that this area will be used for a train station, so they themselves doesn't build inside of this, and also so they can take their own build, let's say if someone plans here, so they can take my build in consideration when they are building their own. Yeah, and if you want to, you can go a bit more advanced. This is just because, well, it's easier for me to know what I'm building when I'm doing these plannings. Also, another rule is that if you wish to build something of the bigger scale, you'll need to ask the Discord for permission, or aka all the other city planners. I mean, if you're just building a high-rise skyscraper in downtown, well, then you don't need to ask for permission. Just go ahead and do your thing and mark it out and start building. But let's say you want to build a arena, a port, a airport, stuff that takes up a lot more area and are like more of a major part of the city, they should be planned a bit more carefully, so the city doesn't end up with 3 airports, 4 huge cargo ports, and 5 arenas within a 1 kilometer area. I mean, you don't need to go overkill with that. Same goes with transit and highways. We've already done maps for those, for how they should be formed. Oh man, what fun. Oh, Marculius joined, lilla jäven. So transit and highways, we have already done map that you need to follow. This is also used to keep the city from turning into a huge highway mess with spaghetti highways everywhere. Yeah, and your building should have an interior, as well as we recommend it to be double floor, though that's not really needed if you don't want to. And I'd appreciate if you build after the city standard, which is rail should be electrified and roads should at least be three to four blocks wide. We're going after more of a European high living standard city, so just so you know. Stop TP to me. Yeah, and that brings us to the actual city. So when you join the server, you can also go to warp downtown. this is the actual city. So the downtown, as the name suggests, is the core of the city. So this is where all the high-rise skyscrapers will be, as well as major transit hubs and so on. You can see the tram here. I'll use the speed 2. You can see the bus hub here. We have a train station down here. For now the downtown is kind of empty. I mean, all the buildings do have an interior, so there's a lot of to explore, but in terms of area it's kind of empty. So if you want to check all of this out yourself, just come on the server and do warp downtown. Yes, then we also have a old town. So as the name suggests, this is the old town of the city with older buildings. So if you're more into old buildings and don't really like building modern stuff, well, this is definitely the place for you to build in. Now this area is even more empty, but we're working on it. The area that have had the most progress, on the other hand, is the international airport built by Markul and Lamet. They have been working quite a lot on this airport for the past few days now, so shout out to them. For now, I only think they are done with the tarmac and runways, it seems like. Yeah, they have at least planned out the terminal, so that's great. And it looks like Markul finished the intersection for the airport. This is kind of a wanky road, but yes. And tunnel is done. Yeah, nice plane, by the way. I think it's Lamet's, so I'm not sure though. I should not have said that, but yeah. It looks good. Yeah. And this is my bridge over here. I finally made a warp for it. I think it's main bridge or something. So this is the bridge that connects the mainland and the airport to the city island. So yeah, it's pretty much done because Markul he did the last bit on it, but yeah, I think it's done pretty much. So yeah, I think that's it. And yeah, here we are planning out some sort of suburb, I think. I think Hamish had some other idea on what this part should be, but I'm not really sure. We're also planning out the port right now, but yeah, nothing has really have not really happened to it. So, well, then the video is basically done. I hope you enjoyed to watch this, and next video will actually be a showcase episode where I show off some builds. So just put your builds on the board and I'll show them off in the next video. So yeah, bye bye, come and join our server.